Shri Ashish Rao. Shri Ashish Rao is a young and innovative engineering graduate from Gudur, Andhra Pradesh. He, in consultation with ICAR SIBA, introduced automation in farming operations and improved the efficiency of the production system. He obtained certification for his farm from the Aquaculture Stewardship Council and Best Aquaculture Practices. He presented his success story on 3C model, clean water, clean seed, and clean pond bottom for successful shrimp farming in the BAFAC 2020 in Surat.
The respected dignitaries and my fellow farmers, I heartfully thank SIBA for giving me this opportunity to be before you. So, brief introduction about me. My name is Nilagiri Ashish. I'm a pilot turned commerce graduate with MBA in marketing and HR. So I'm basically a second generation farmer, and my father and uncle are in the industry for past 28 years. So I'd like to continue with the presentation where we would be discussing about our farm history. This is my uncle and this is me. Our area where we do culture is Nellore. So these are the certifications we have, BAP and ASC. And these are the few felicitations we have received. So since they've asked me to speak in Hindi, my Hindi is not good, so kindly bear with me. हम स्मार्ट फार्म को क्यों बदले? हमारा सोर्स ऑफ पानी था कनलेर क्रीक, विच इज़ वन ऑफ द लॉन्गेस्ट क्रीक्स इन इंडिया. हमारा फार्म मिड स्ट्रीम में लोकेट हुआ था, एंड सिंस 2015 वी डिडंट हैव एनी रेनफॉल, ड्यू टू विच आर सेलिनिटीज हैव इंक्रीज्ड एंड आर वाटर पैरामीटर्स हैव चेंज एब्रप्टली. द NTU लेवल्स, द टर्बिडिटी लेवल्स एंड अमोनिया, pH, विब्रियो लोड्स ऑल हैव इंक्रीज्ड. द डिफिकल्टीज विच वी फेस्ड वर slow average daily growth, white feces problem, high FCR, low survival rate, and low cost of production. These were the turbidity levels. You can see the clean water and the water in our creek. So before we shifted to smart farm, the number of crops we were doing in a year is one crop. Farm structure was 10% reservoir, 90% area. Problems, white feces, WSSV, more algae, high turbidity. Cost of production, approximately 315 rupees per kilo. So the return on investment was very slow. Yield per hectare is 3.5 ton. This was our farm design. The 2.3 hectare is the reservoir and 17.5 hectare with 20 ponds. But after restructuring, you can see, yeah. It's 4.3 hectare reservoir and 13.4 hectare which consists of 19 ponds, and there's a nursery system along with a fast mixing unit. This you can see that the chlorination treatment where we are giving with the fast mixing unit. The quality of water you can see, and you'll see in the next video the output water. It's very turbid and not good for culture. This is the water after treatment. The turbidity levels are more than 70. And after the treatment with 60% bleaching and 15 ppm of PAC, this is basically our structure of the farm, wherein you can see that the total length of the reservoir is almost 375 meter, wherein when we made baffle walls, it became up to 1250 meters where the water was traveling, due to which we could reduce turbidity and alkalinity levels. This is the clean water after treatment. The turbidity levels are below 1.24, you can see here. This is our farm structure. Basically, good seed, clean nursery, and without any use of antibiotics and help of probiotics and complete biosecurity, we are able to achieve better profits with clean seed, clean water, and clean pond bottom. The benefits of smart farm: we can avoid disease outbreak, increase yield per hectare, and reduce the cost of production. So this is basically our nursery. We usually use three-line aeration system, and all of our ponds have shrimp toilets. So because of which we can control the sludge and we can make the pond bottom very clear. We use 3C concept, and after shifting the seed from nursery at 30 to 45 days, it achieves 2.3 to 4 grams. The costing which we are incurring in nursery is 1.15 rupees per piece. So in a 76 days, in a grow out pond, we are able to come up to 35 to 30 count. So the cost of production also we are reducing by almost 35 rupees. You can find it as 270. In year 2015, when we went with direct stocking, our average daily growth was somewhere between 1.5. 2016, average daily growth after nursery, inculcation of nursery, it is 0.25. And in 2017-18, after we built shrimp toilets and sludge removal, the average daily growth is 0.35. And we use different kinds of technology to minimize labor and minimize cross-contamination between the ponds. We engaged all auto feeders. As you can see, we continuously monitor them, with which we are able to achieve low FCRs and better production at a faster rate. You can see the return on investment with this system, we are able to get it 52%, which is much faster than a regular system. And the production, you can see, we are able to achieve 7 ton per hectare, wherein our salinities are almost between 30 to 45. We monitor shrimp on a regular basis for sampling, and we take decisions accordingly, give optimum feed to the shrimp so that it avoids eating mud and saves you from white feces or other diseases. You can see there the shrimp with full feed gut, and here the shrimp with black gut. So that's eating feed, and this video you can see it has eaten mud. So this is the healthy shrimp with full gut and good condition. So keep your water level maximum for more DO, for more pond bearing capacity. And stable water parameters. If you reach a pond bearing capacity, your growth usually comes down below 1.5 grams. And your running mortality starts, and loose shell, and you lose survival rates. So when you find you reach your pond bearing capacity, we need to harvest, at least do a partial harvest or remove sludge from the ponds or add new water to the system. These are the auto feeder benefits which we have seen. Good average daily growth, low FCR, we need less manpower, and cross-contamination is avoided, low production cost. So these are the technologies which we are engaged with for monitoring all our electrical systems, by which we are able to monitor even weekly FCRs. We have put some technologies wherein some electrical systems or aeration gets off, we get messages and calls. So now after the smart farm technology, the number of crops we are doing per year is 2. The reservoir area is 30% and the culture area is 70% after restructuring. The problems are manageable and the cost of production we got down. So return on investment is much faster. The nursery management is 30% and your grow out culture management is 70%. These are the few people and few MPEDA people who visited our site. So our present culture model is 30 to 40 days in nursery and 60 to 75 days in grow out. We are able to achieve 30 to 40 count. And this year we are planning for a second nursery. After 40 days we are planning to shift to second nursery, wherein we'll be growing up to 17 grams, and a third grow out pond in 30 days we'll be able to achieve 30 count. So basically in 100 days you are able to finish your culture. Yeah. Wish you a profitable, happy harvest. Thank you.